We never put a lottery and you won the lottery. Have you ever heard Dr. Nikon? You never put money to the lottery and you won the lottery. All right. This is a special award for my most loving and good doctor, meet and adjourn before the lecture. before she give the lecture. डॉक्टर साहब आपका सेरेमनी हो गया ना, ग्रेजुएशन सेरेमनी हुआ? हो गया जी, मैंने कब फिक्र हो गई है एक बोल लाइन है. And now I leave in the good hands of my dear Dr. Mirza Najirullah. Please.
Dear colleagues, my name is Dr. Mirjana Živano. Today I will talk about karmic remedies in the light of the matrix method. We can often hear that our world is built on the idea of power opposites for everything, darkness and light, hot and cold, wet and dry. When one of the power opposites takes over, it gets pushed back by the other, like the movements of the pendulum. So what we see is the dual nature of the universe. If we freeze the image, make a snapshot, but if we let it roll in front of our eyes like a movie, we can see the third element, the force that makes the two move and change, where each one of these three elements are influenced by the other two. So the two opposites are bound together by the force, the third, giving the universe its tripartite nature, symbolized by a triangle. So when we see two, it's in fact three. Very deep down in the multicellular organisms, there are three basic monoamines, serotonin, noradrenaline, and dopamine, that shape the behavioral and emotional patterns. We use the Detractis model to visualize the behavioral and emotional states shaped by the ratio and predominance of which one of these three monoamines, serotonin, dopamine, and noradrenaline, and it is one of the key elements of the matrix method in homeopathy. So the Detractis model presents the basic emotions and behaviors, intense fears, based on ratios of the three monoamines, serotonin, dopamine, and noradrenaline. And we can see the high serotonin level is associated with the top sphere of Detractis, the sphere control and contempt. High dopamine level is associated with the bottom right corner and the sphere anticipation of reward. And high noradrenaline level is associated with the bottom left corner and the sphere anxious and aroused. In homeopathy, Hahnemann has defined three miasms as something that lays beneath the deep and overwhelming influence. The Hahnemann's miasms can be associated with our three monoamines, serotonin, dopamine, and noradrenaline. The spheres influenced by serotonin are associated with syphilitic miasm and form the syphilitic triangle of Detractis. The spheres influenced by dopamine are associated with psoric miasm and form the psoric triangle of Detractis. And the spheres influenced by noradrenaline are associated with psychotic miasm and form the psychotic triangle of Detractis. So here we can see all three miasmatic triangles in one image. There is a huge gap between what we wish and what we need, and the similium always gives a patient what he or she needs at the time, sometimes with obvious, even miraculous effects, and other times it will start the chain of events that will in time prove to be beneficial for the patient. That is why a healthy individual needs to be on his or her similimum, and it should never be expected to act like some stimulant. It is our guard, our silent companion, our guardian angel, not a party friend. So, we should be very careful when to prescribe karmic or situational remedy if our patient is already on similimum therapy, because it may disrupt a silent long-term action of the similimum. But once the similimum achieves a stable state in a person, the karmic issues may open up, and then the karmic remedy becomes necessary. There are many situations in life that may get a person out of himself, out of his similimum. These are usually very strong or long-lasting influences. When a person is out of himself, out of his similimum, we usually just need to prescribe the similimum, and everything falls back into place. But after some time of stability on similimum, the karmic issues start to surface, and then we have to prescribe that new karmic or situational remedy for that new totality of symptoms, karmic or situational remedy. We are born with coping mechanisms adapted to our own miasm, our behavior, even humoral reactions. But if we get pulled out into a different miasm, we are fundamentally lost, and it may lead to grave illnesses. And these are the states in which a person overcompensates, and in time it leads to exhaustion. So I will be presenting Borak's case. We have a regular patient, a woman, coming for follow-ups every 2 months for years. And first time when she came to us, she was very sad because of the sudden death of her husband. And we took her case and we found that her sole remedy, her similimum, was phosphorus, based on the classical case-taking and on matrix method. Her Tetractys model and her code, something, nothing, showed us her similimum, phosphorus. So he got angry and beat her up. When her mother came home, she complained her how her stepfather was beating her and how she feels horrible now, but her mother just replied, "Oh, it's nothing to be scared of." That made her feel much worse. She felt miserable. She was crying for months. At that time, she started to attend the first year of elementary school, and she remembered how she couldn't speak up or read out loud. She could only read to herself. We can see how she practically got down from that stress. She also remembered during one family celebration how her cousin noticed how her stepfather was rude to her, and it resulted in a fight. Her mother, who was pregnant at that time with her second child, lost her conscience in a shock, and she got a delivery 2 weeks early because of that stress. After the baby was born, everybody was preoccupied with the baby, so she felt free. She started to talk, to stood up for herself. She got straight A's in school, and before that mostly C's. She used to be the worst pupil in the class, and after that she became the best one. Now, our patient was asking herself if she was responsible for her son's divorce, attracted that situation by suppressing all those emotions from her childhood. She said how she was crying all the time, and now she was crying on this follow-up. And she said this is the first time ever she told this to anyone. Conclusion, we noticed that her father was kind of dead to her since she was a baby. And when she came to us, her husband just died. And it is known that the daughter's relationship with father transfers to her relationship with husband. On her similimum phosphorus, she felt fine and in balance for years, but because of her son's divorce, like a trigger, the old images from the past came back when her parents had divorced. So she remembered how she was crying all the time at that time, and she was crying all the time during this follow-up. I have to underline, for all these years, she was our patient. She didn't cry once during follow-ups. Those emotions were suppressed very deep, and now the time has come to deal with them. The energy of this karmic team that opened had a very high emotional charge, and it attracted the repeating of similar situations, like the situation with her son's divorce. So, similar situations are repeating in one's life if they are not energetically resolved. They are repeating in order to be resolved. The first remedy we prescribed was Borax and Eta C200 with the polarities miserable exhilaration. It is the sorrow of a 1.5-year-old baby in the situation of the parents' divorce, and this sorrow is still present in our patient, but it wasn't expressed until now. After the remedy, she will not be tormented with this theme as she was before the remedy, not even close. We can see the presence of tormenting feeling of all acid remedies. We can see all the key themes associated with the acids, tormenting because of separation, not accepting the new situation, complaints that no one hears them, and long-lasting states. We can also see the stramonium theme, her shock after her stepfather's beating, and even bigger shock when her mother ignored her complaints. Also, she said how she was afraid of her stepfather, and the stramonium is the other precode for the remedy Borax Veneta, and we can see how the stramonium, primordial polarity horror, opens the door to the miserable state of Borax Veneta. After the remedy, stramonium, she slept better. She said she used to wake up several times during the night because of bad dreams. She felt braver in everyday life because her polarity horror was diminished by being integrated into the code for stramonium horror rescue. If she would have felt hatred towards her stepfather, she would enter the state of phosphoric acid, but she didn't. She was only talking about being miserable. In phosphoric acid state, children become destructive to everything around them and eventually to themselves, and she was just sad and she was talking only about being miserable. Borax Veneta is a salt of boric acid and is prescribed for old wounds. Feeling miserable, many tears have been shed. But now it's only a salt at the bottom of a dry lake, but this salt carries emotions within, and it can easily absorb water, return back into the acid, and rekindle old emotions, and that is exactly what happened to this patient of ours. Psychotic children will usually enter the state of Borax Veneta. They feel scared, alone, abandoned, horror, powerless, and at the end miserable. They can't adjust to a new situation, they get petrified in one place. They are in some kind of spasm, which comes from the remedy Ignatia Amara, the other precode for the remedy Borax Veneta. The children of syphilitic miasm will enter the state of phosphoric acid. They often see it as they've got more space for themselves to do whatever they want. They may start to make a mess of their lives, get into bad company, start stealing or doing drugs. So Borax Veneta has two precodes, Ignatia Amara, with polarities powerless joy. The other precode, Stramonium, with polarities horror rescue. Borax Veneta is the remedy for the victims of a situation. The parent that was left also entered the state of Borax Veneta, like the children, if they belong to psychotic miasm. But before they feel miserable, they felt powerless and horror. The two polarities of the two precodes of remedy Borax Veneta. Phosphoric acid has two precodes, silica terra with the code safe insecure, and the other precode, hyper sulfur, beautiful, ugly, or disgusting. Phosphoric acid is the remedy for the perpetrator, for the parent that leaves. A person in phosphoric acid state feels hatred while living, but before that it was insecure and disgust, the two polarities of the two precodes of the remedy phosphoric acid. In an acute state, when a baby or a child experiences a separation from the parent, the most suitable remedy would probably be a boric acid. It's a situation with much crying, sorrow, a baby struggle to accept such a new situation, but as the time passes and the person moves on, that acute state transforms into a chronic one with very deep suppressed emotions, and for that chronic state with these suppressed emotions, the most suitable remedy would probably be Borax Veneta. We can recognize an energetic and karmic chain forged by behavior of family members in a sequence of events that leads to separation. So the karmic story continues. It's just a part of chain of events, the end is nowhere to be seen. We don't know how did the father of our patient feel, but we heard he had 5 wives and many children. We may assume that his state didn't change. He was getting in and out of roles of perpetrator and savior, entering and leaving marriages. First he was feeling love when he was entering marriage, and then hatred when he was leaving. He was just moving from one primordial polarity to another of his karmic remedy, phosphoric acid. Trapped in this chain are even their pets, because they're influenced by these energies too. We heard many times a patient saying something like, I was so nervous, but at the end I beat up the dog instead of children. As animals are emotional beings, they become trapped in our karmic chains too. So we can't see the end of these chains. So what we can do with our homeopathic therapy is to break out of that state of separation and it being transferred to the following generations. We may diminish or even remove the attraction of this path taken by many who came before. By giving the situational, in this case karmic remedy, we may not only break the chain of events, but maybe even extend our therapy to the patient's ancestors who live their lives in the same chains. The chain is broken and that same old story stops repeating. We can see in our detractis model the spheres of detractis. When the patient came to us, she was very sad after the sudden death of her husband, and she was in the sphere sadness of her syphilitic triangle of detractis. And then he gave her simulium phosphorus, she simply got back into her predominant spheres, exhilaration with empathy, peace and joy of her simulium phosphorus. But now, in this karmic situation that opened up, she steps out of her syphilitic triangle of detractis into the sphere sadness and fear of psychotic triangle of detractis. When a person steps out of her triangle of detractis, it is a very unnatural state for that person, and we can see in our example how she couldn't speak up or read out loud, how she could read only to herself, how she practically got down from that stress, and it was difficult for her to learn to write. But then her sibling was born, and she started to talk and to felt free, and she simply naturally got back into her syphilitic triangle of detractis, but at that time she suppressed all those emotions very deep. And now when her son divorced, like a trigger, the old images from the past came back, and that suppressed emotions came to the surface, and it was the best time now to give her her karmic remedy, Borax Veneta. So after the remedy Borax Veneta, she got back into her syphilitic triangle of detractis, and in her predominant spheres, peace and joy and exhilaration with empathy of her simulium phosphorus. In the future, she will not be tormented with this theme anymore because the high emotional charges have been removed. So now she can talk about that and she doesn't cry all the time because she doesn't have that charges anymore. Themes in common for phosphoric acid and borax veneta remedies: unexpected, sudden, shock, long-lasting states, tormenting feeling, separation, unacceptance, complaints that no one hears them, tears borax, no tears phosphoric acid, rudeness, sensitive to rudeness is borax veneta, while phosphoric acid is often being rude, stiffness, paralysis. Things for borax veneta only: staying still, scared, alone, unproductive, pre-codes, stramonium with the polarity horror, and Ignatia Amara with polarity powerless, open the door to the miserable state of borax veneta with the code miserable exhilaration. The themes for phosphoric acid only: disgust, living, free, movement, radical and quick solutions, destruction, knife's blood, ending something. Recodes Heperson with the polarity disgust and silica terra with the polarity insecurity opened the door to the hatred feeling of phosphoric acid with the code love hate. So we always try to give the simulimum first, but karmic chains run strong in the families, so karmic remedies have to follow to heal and unite. Also, I've got some news: the 2 books on the Matrix Method have just been published by Blitzani. And you can see the books here. Thank you.
Thank you, Mirjana. Enjoy.